All right, let us start. Today's concept is software myths. Okay, what is a myth here? Myth is one kind of belief. Okay, which kind of belief it is? It may be a true belief or false. Okay, there are two kinds of beliefs are there in real worlds. That is, one is either it is true or it is false. Okay, but now in our subject, in our software engineering, we are going to discuss about myths with false beliefs, okay, or otherwise untruth things or attitudes. Now we are going to discuss about this. Okay, so actually this beliefs is depends on software development. The software development, okay, includes three kinds of participants. The complete project development includes three kinds of participants. So those participants are software management, customers, and developers. Okay, in earlier classes we have discussed about these participants. Okay, these participants are involved in software development. They will play the roles, different roles in that particular software development, and these three participants have different kinds of myths, are called different kinds of beliefs while developing a software. These three kinds of participants have different false beliefs. They trust some untruth. Clear? So this what for, because of these false beliefs, this may lead some serious problems while developing a software. Okay, so let us discuss what are the management myths, customer myths, and developer myth. First one is software management myths, which means whoever the people related to a organization, okay, or management with people, whoever developing such, I mean agreed to develop such kind of software projects. So they have their own some set of beliefs. Okay, so those are the wrong beliefs. What is the first wrong belief? That they trust strongly. Means, first one is development problems can be solved by developing and documenting standards. So while developing a project, we may get some kind of problems. Okay, so some kind of problems or issues while developing a project. If any project will get such kinds of problems, okay, that problems can be solved by developing standards or document standards. Okay, they thought like that, they are thinking like that. So what are the standards? Okay, those are the rules and regulations, okay, which is developed by some organizations or some companies. What are the standards here? Standards are rules and regulations which have been developed by a companies or organizations, okay, for getting a some qualitative product or project. So actually, while during of a real-time project development, okay, that standards may be followed or may not be followed by a developers. Maybe that rules are not fulfilled the all the needs of a project. Maybe those are irrelevant to project, or otherwise there are those are incomplete to project, okay, or otherwise the people don't know about that rules and regulations of that particular organization. Like that, okay, coming to a real world, there are different things, different possibilities are occur by developing a project. So there is no, we can't say so each and everything is followed accordingly the standards of a organization, isn't it? Suppose, for example, there is a strict rule in our college. Assume that there is a strict rule in our college that all students must maintain a dress code. What it is? All students must maintain a dress code. Okay, in the dress code also, maybe there are different rules, there are different things are included in that. Okay, dress code in the sense, what we feel that only one uniform, one shirt, one pant, or one dress. Okay, that is, we thought that is a dress code. Okay, not exactly that is a dress code. From top to bottom, okay, even we need to wear a tie. Okay, you should wear shoes, okay, or something that to polish it shows, like ironed cloths, like each and every pinpoint. If girls are there, means they must tie their hair with some band, and they'll wear with the chunni with by using some pins, like that. Each and every small point and big point is included into that rule, okay, dress code. So are we following exactly that dress code? No. Only few of us is following. Remaining all are neglecting. That is not a big issue. Okay. It's not a consider. It is not like a big issue. But whenever coming to 100%, we should follow. That is a standard or that is a rule developed by a college. You must follow 100% means. Okay, then somebody may because of their facilities, lack of facilities, they didn't follow that one. Okay, so they will feel little difficulty because of that rules. Okay, and so we may follow or not. So little bit we are neglecting such kind of rules, isn't it? So here also, while developing a project, some management or organization, okay, make some rules and regulations, and also they thought that whatever the problem is raised, okay, during a project development, so we are having all some set of rules already. So while studying that rules or by reading that rules, so all problems will solved. Okay, is it correct opinion? No. That's a wrong belief. While developing a project, it's a completely wrong belief. Why? Because that rules are maybe very strict rules. Okay, by using that rules, we can't implement the project exactly. Okay, and one more thing. If that project, for completion of that project, there are different standards and different rules are there. We need to deviate little bit. Otherwise, we can't work under exact rules and exact standards. Under standards. Okay. because maybe those are the older standards, or because they are incomplete, they are not suitable to today's working and working develop, I mean working nature, and many problems will be there in that older rules and regulations. We can't follow each and every one. Okay, so that is one wrong belief by a management of software companies. Coming to second one is, what is the second myth means? Development problems can be solved by using art of the art tools. Here, to develop a project, we need some tools, isn't it? Without tools, we can't make anything, right? We can't construct or we can't implement anything. So the tools may help to us, but with the tools also we need to work. Okay, we need to work out a lot. Otherwise, by putting bare the one tool, and is it worked selfly? It's impossible. If a charger is there, phone is there. Okay, we'll put charger one side and phone beside of that, means it will charge without without attaching pin to that phone. No, it won't work. If you want to get charge your mobile, you should insert a pin into your mobile and switch on that. Okay, otherwise, by having a charger itself, it won't work, isn't it? So like that, if you have some some tools in your organization, okay, with the tools also the developer must work. Okay, so the tools also may be support to that particular project or not. The tools, we can't say that tools must be supported or not to solve a problem, or otherwise, okay, it related to a customer needs. Clear? So tools in the sense, compulsory, that company must have the each and every tool, and also the tools also work according to the requirements of a customer, and the developer knows how to use the tools, how to handle the situations by using new technologies or new old technologies, how to overcome the situations, okay, how to use some gadget, how to use some techniques to develop a software. So what they thought, okay, the management people are thinking, whatever the tools we have inside in our organization, that is enough to build a software or complete a software project. But that is not a 100% okay true belief. That tools may be supported or may not be supported to develop that project. Okay, so that is the second myth. And coming to the third one, here the same point is repeated, but that is not a third one. Okay, I may explain you the third one. When schedules slip, just add more people. What the managers think in third myth, that is, when schedules slip, which means if management has given some schedule to complete that project, okay, so if that project is not completed within the schedule, okay, the team members, whatever the team is allotted to complete that particular project, is not enough. The people is not enough. Okay, so in such a cases, what they thought means, okay, they think, okay, we will add more new people and we'll get ready that project within a schedule like that they'll think. Okay, whenever it's a less number of people are working in a particular project, okay, that people is not enough to complete that project. So then management will think, okay, we will add at the middle of the project or before going to complete that project, they will add more number of new people to that project and they'll get ready the project within a time. Like that they think. Okay, that's not a good practice. Why? Because if time is not sufficient to complete a project with the existing team people, then better ask or increase the time schedule by requesting a customer. Okay. Excuse me. Sorry. Here. So, adding of new people while developing a project at middle of the project or at the ending stage of the project is not a good practice. Why? Because, okay, if you will add new people also, okay, for understanding of that project, it is little difficult to a new people. Okay, and also there is a communication gap will created in between old existing project working nature and for new people. Okay, new people will understand that problem project and also they'll cooperate to existing people and they'll work togetherly. It's a complicated thing. Okay, adding of new team members while working off one project means it's a little complicated thing. Okay, so it may leads to extension of the time. So better to continue that project with the existing people itself by requesting the time from a customer, or otherwise they reschedule that project time itself. Okay, that is the third myth. So what they think means, if a project schedule is it will be slipped, so then just we will add more people to complete that project. Like that they will think. Okay, now we will start with two or three members. If they will be completed within a time, it's okay. If not, at the end of the project, we will join more two or three members, okay, to complete this project. Like that, they'll think. That is a wrong belief while working on a software industry or software development. Isn't it? So, these are the three wrong beliefs by a software management. And next, we'll see the customer myths. Okay, here the customer also has some strong myths. Okay, what are those means? The first one is, change is easily accommodated since software is malleable, which means software can be accepted any kind of change immediately. Whenever we want to change that project, we will ask and they will change. The developers and the management who is there, the management will be accepted. Then the developers will be work easily. Okay, whenever we need changes in that project, like that, the customer will think generally. Okay, this is also one kind of wrong beliefness. Why? Because if something is constructed based on some requirements, isn't it?
If after few days, after a month, if you are asked to change that project to some other way, okay, is it possible to change that much? Okay, if for example, if one project is changed, okay, before going to start the construction, it's possible. If one person now we are constructing one building. Assume that we are constructing one building. If before going to start the construction of building, any changes are there, means it's okay. Everybody can accept it and we'll start to construct a building after that. But after construction is finished, just finished, okay, after that, he asked for made the changes in this construction. Okay, I don't want the kitchen that side, move this kitchen to this side. Or I don't want to one living room, I need two living rooms, like that. Okay, he is asking for some changes. And he thought that changes will be possible easily. Why? Because software is a very easiest thing, like that he thought. Okay, that's a wrong belief by a customer. Why? Because after complete construction, if we are trying to do any modifications, okay, it's looking like nice. Maybe sometimes it's good, but sometimes not. Okay, after complete construction, if we want to split one room into two rooms, means it's okay. But if we want to move kitchen from left side to right side, means is it possible? No. Some impossible things also happen. So in such kinds of things, mentalities have the customers have such kind of mentalities here. Okay, they thought that after developed also, after finishing of that also, after 1 year, whenever I want to change, I can change. After 2 years, I can change. Like that, they thought that is a one material. So it's like a clay. Why we are using a clay? For making some small toys, isn't it? Okay, after making one toy, after 1 hour, we are going to get that one back, and once again we are going to make another toy by using clay, isn't it? So they thought that software project is also like that. It's like one clay. Whenever we want to modify, I will modify easily. Like that they are thinking. Okay, that is a one wrong think by a customer about a software. Clear? Coming to second myth of a customer is, a software is a general statement of needed is sufficient to start coding. What he think is, just it's a, if we want to start a coding of a software, it is in a general language. Okay, what is the front page of every application? It is some alphabets, English, one photo, something, little some text box, some labels are available, okay, are visible in front page of a software. They thought that, what they'll think, okay, software means each and everything is understood by a user. Okay, it is prepared in a general regular language. So it will take less time to complete, less time to implement. It is a very easy work. Okay, they don't need much time to complete this one. Okay, they don't need the much talent, much capacity to complete the work of a design or some software. Okay, and no need of any coding knowledge also. And it is finished off just a general language, general statements. Like that, he will think. Whoever, okay, don't know about a software coding and background work and something, how that is working. okay, process of each and every button, each and every option, whoever don't know that one, so they thought that it's a just a general language like English language. Okay, for developing this one, there is no need of experts, there is no need of coding experts or some other experts. Just if I learn a computer, how to work with the computer, then I'll prepare a what application, software application. Like that, they'll think. Okay, that is the second wrong belief by a customer. But it's a software development means it's a single person work. No, it's a team work. So some experts are working on that. It's not a just general statements of coding. It's a lot of work into that. Lot of functions are there. So it's a lot of skilled work. But according to a customer, it's a simple work. Clear? This is about software customer myths. And coming to the third one, developer myths. Developer myths, whoever developing the software, which means coding experts. Coding experts, testing experts, technical people related to a project. Whoever the technical people are related to a project is called a developers. So they are also having some kind of wrong beliefs. What are those? Coming to the first one, the job is done when the code is delivered. What they are thinking here? Our work is finished. Our job is finished when we deliver a project or when we finished a code. Okay, when we hand over a project to a customer, like that, they'll think. Okay, if their work is finished at that point, so there is no maintenance, there is no service in future. If no service, no maintenance in future means, okay, what is the guarantee? And who will trust our project? Nobody will trust. Okay, if some car showrooms are now we are going and purchasing one car. After purchasing a car, they said we don't have any kind of service centers. We don't have any maintenance, something. If anything is repaired, nothing is there. Okay, like this, if they will tell us, means we'll buy such a car? No. After delivering a project also, okay, they have some accountability. After taking that one, if any problems will come, okay, after immediately, after 1 month, after 2 months, after 1 year or something, okay, they'll address that problems, they'll clear that problems, they must clear that problems. They should provide some service centers. Why? Because they have developed that car with some technology, with some parts. So they have the complete idea about that technology and parts. That's why if they will repair that one, means it is very easy for them as well as to the customer also, and maintaining. So if we'll go for each and every time for servicing and maintaining only, okay, it will it will work for more number of years. Okay, it will work for long duration. Otherwise, it won't work. It will stop somewhere else due to some problem. Okay, we don't know what is the problem. The customer don't know what is the problem. And so users also don't know the problem, what happened to that particular app. And whoever new persons, if we'll show that person, new persons also didn't understand the technology of that project and something inside in the, what's inside into that project. So the total project is wasted. So that's why if any kind of errors are happened, okay,
while using the project, the developers should address that errors. Okay, they frequently check that such kind of project yearly once or twice. Okay, they should provide maintenance also, service also for such kind of that customers after you developed a project. Okay, that is a good practice of a developer. But what they are thinking here, they thought that after delivery a project, we don't have any work with them. We don't have any communication with them. Like that, they'll think. So that is a one of the wrong myth by a developer. Clear? Coming to second point. Project success depends solely on the quality of the delivered program. What they are thinking, so project success, if one project is successful, okay, it's good. So what they are thinking, so whatever the coding they are developed, whatever the program they have written for that program, a project, because of that one, only that project is successful. They are thinking like that. If one project is successful, that project is successful because of their program knowledge. Okay, like that, they are thinking. Okay, only coding is enough for a program? No. Okay, there is a teamwork from starting to ending. Before going to start a project, there is a lot of work related to project with talking of a customer, okay, and taking a notes about the requirements of a customer. After that, requirements gathering, analysis, real-time analysis, real-time gathering, okay, and designing. So many steps are involved into this project success. Okay, even though if one project is successed, we may tell because of the documentation and the software configuration. Okay, documentation and the software configurations also play important role in a success of a project. Not completely because of a coding, not completely because of a programs, not because of a single person. Okay, one project is successful because of many people, because of teamwork, lot of members effect. Okay, so in that project's success, maybe because of management people or because of what a customer, because of developer, everybody is involved if something has been successed, isn't it? But though don't think that is purely the developer's effect. Okay, that is a one kind of wrong belief. Clear? And last one is, third one in developer's myth is, you can't assess software quality until the program is running. What they are thinking? So until the program is completed, after completed only it will show some results. Okay, after getting that results only we will assess the quality of that project. Like that they are thinking. No, it's a wrong perception. Why? Because there are many static ways are available to check the quality of a project. There are many static ways are there to check the project quality and also whether it will work properly or not. Okay, no need of waiting until the running. No need of waiting until the complete completion of that project. Okay, some physical estimations, some mathematical estimations also, by applying some mathematical estimations also, we can estimate that project quality, whether it will work, okay, according to a requirement or not, with quality or not. Like that, we are having many static estimations or measurements are there to check a project, to check a quality of that project. Clear? So, or otherwise, if some expert people are one guy is working on hundreds of projects means, if we show our project to him, means he automatically says whether it will work correctly or not. Why? Because he had experience on many projects, means he can easily guess about that project itself, isn't it? So such kind of things are available in market, but developers, what they think? So after the finishing of this project only we will get the results, and we will estimate whether we will tell exactly it is working properly or not, like that. But that's not a good thing and correct thinking. Clear? This is about the myths or wrong beliefs by a participants of a software. Hope you understood. Thank you.